各位牧者同工，还有线上的弟兄姐妹，平安。
Peace to you all pastors, co-workers, and also brothers and sisters who are listening online.
昨天我们读了以斯帖的一到三章。
Yesterday we have read of the book of Esther, chapter 1 to 3.
说到呢，哈曼就向亚哈水鲁王献祭。
Mentioned that Haman offered to King Ahasuerus,
要灭掉他们统治的127省当中的所有的犹太人。
In order to destroy all the Jews in the 127 provinces.
这其实是一个死局来的。
Actually, this is a genocide.
是法令下去要成就的事情。
And what has been sent off through the decree and it shall come to pass.
但是今天的四到六章呢？
But today, chapter 4 to 6,
就说了非常重要的一个关键的事情。
Has mentioned something critical.
而这个关键的事情呢，就带来这整个的局势有一个的扭转。
And this critical moment brings about a turnaround.
我们也看到在这样子一个危急的状况，到底神的百姓如何可以去做一个翻转的动作呢？
And in this critical moment, how the people of God can have a change and what they do.
弟兄姐妹，我们也是在一个很艰难的状况。
Brothers and sisters, we are also in a difficult situation.
但是在那个时代，以斯帖的时代呢，他们经历了神一个很大的拯救。
But in the generation of Esther, they have experienced a salvation deliverance from God.
他们跟神同行同工的方法，我相信今天也适用在我们当中。
The way that they co-work with the Lord, I believe we can also use it today.
我给今天一个主题叫做进入神蒙恩拯救的时机。
I give it a title today that is entering into the timing of God's grace and salvation.
分成三大段。
I'll separate into three paragraphs.
第一大段是第四章，禁食祷告启动转机。
And the first paragraph is chapter 4, fast and pray to activate the turning point.
第二段是第五章，等候让神成就大事。
And the second paragraph is chapter 5, wait for God to do great things.
第三段是第六章，有神尊荣，仇敌必败。
Third paragraph is chapter 6, with God's honor, the enemy is defeated.
我们就一起来看四章的一到三节。
Let us look at chapter 4, verse 1 to 3.
莫迪改知道所做的这一切事，就撕裂衣服，穿麻衣，蒙灰尘，在城中行走，痛痛哀嚎，到了朝门前，停住脚步，因为穿麻衣的不可进朝门。王的谕旨所到的各省各处，犹大人大大悲哀，禁食哭泣哀嚎，穿麻衣躺在灰中的甚多。
When Mordecai learned all that had happened, he tore his clothes and put on sackcloth and ashes and went out into the midst of the city. He cried out with a loud and bitter cry. He went as far as the front of the king's gate, for no one might enter the king's gate clothed with sackcloth. And in every province where the king's command and decree arrived, there was great mourning among the Jews, with fasting, weeping, and wailing, and many laid in sackcloth and ashes.
当莫迪改一知道他们要被灭的时候呢
？As soon as Mordecai knew that they were about to be exterminated,
他马上就穿上麻衣，然后就开始哀嚎。
He immediately put on sackcloth and wailed.
这是一个动作，他马上来到神的面前，来向神来呼求。
This is his action. That is immediately he come to God and also cry out to God.
我相信不只是他这样子做，他也带动很多的犹太人跟他一起来进食，向神呼求。
I believe not only himself, but he bring along many of the Jews to come and fast and pray to God.
一起求神真的是来救他们的命。
Pray to God in order to save them.
在此刻，宫中的以斯帖呢，并不知道宫外发生什么事情。
At this time, Esther, who was in the palace, did not know what is happening outside the palace.
她听说了莫迪改穿着麻衣，她就觉得很奇怪。她马上派了人去跟她讲，要换掉这个衣服。
He heard people told her that Mordecai was on sackcloth, and immediately she sent someone to ask Mordecai to change, not to wear the sackcloth.
但是她不愿意。
But he is not willing.
以斯帖呢，就再派他的太监。哈塔格去问
，And once more, Esther sent her eunuch Hatta to ask what is happening.
到底发生了什么事呢
？What is happening?
莫迪改就一五一十的把整个事情，还有哈曼，甚至要用钱来收买整个的王，然后去成就这件事情。
And Esther told everything to Mordecai, and even how Haman wanted to bribe the king and to slaughter all the Jews.
他也把王下的指令呢，写一份给以斯帖。
He also copied a copy of the decree which was set by the king to Esther.
他对以斯帖说：“你要去为了你的族群来见王求恩呐。”
And he asked her to go to the king and plead for her people.
但是在这时刻，以斯帖其实是一个非常艰难的时刻。
Actually, Esther is in a very difficult situation.
因为她已经有三十天没有见到王了。
Because for 30 days she had not seen the king.
而且在第二章的时候，那里也有说到，其实王选了以斯帖做王后之后，没有多久的时间，他又再次的遭拒嫔妃，要纳入成为他的太太。
And actually, in chapter 2 also mentioned that not long after he ordained Queen Esther as the queen, and he started another election to take more concubines.
所以从这个过程里面，我们可以看到以斯帖已经没有像当初他被选上的时候，在王的心中是这么的哇，很宝贝他。
So we can see that Queen Esther is not as precious as the time when she was selected as the queen.
而且在当时候，如果贸贸然的去见王，没有王的一个召见的时候，是要被处死的。
If the king did not summon to see her and she go to meet the king, actually she will be put to death.
所以她心中有许多的担忧。
So there is a lot of worries inside of her.
莫迪改知道以斯帖的心情之后
，When Mordecai know how Esther felt,
在四章十四节这样说：“此时你若闭口不言，犹大人必从别。”处得解脱，蒙拯救，你和你父家必致灭亡。焉知你得了王后的位分，不是为现今的这个机会吗？
Then in verse 14, Mordecai said, "For if you remain completely silent at this time, relief and deliverance will arise for the Jews from another place, but you and your father's house will perish. Yet who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this?"
后来以斯帖就回应。莫迪改说：“你去召聚苏三城所有的犹大人，为我禁食三昼三夜，不吃不喝。我和我的宫女也要这样禁食。然后我违例进去见王，我若死就死吧。”于是莫迪改照以斯帖一切所吩咐的去行。
Then Esther replied in verse 16 and 17, "Go gather all the Jews who are present in Shushan and fast for me." Neither eat nor drink for 3 days, night or day. My mates and I shall fast likewise. And so I will go to the king, which is against the law. And if I perish, I perish. So Mordecai went his way and did according to all that Esther commanded him.
这个禁食祷告在这个时间点是非常重要的。
This fast and pray at this moment of time is very important.
特别以斯帖对他们讲说，你们为我禁食三昼三夜。
Especially when Esther mentioned that,You fast and pray for me 3 days, night or day.
我相信那时候的以斯帖其实心中是有很多的感觉，有很多他一直在挣扎的状况。
I believe Esther at that time has a lot of feeling inside and also her struggle.
她可能面临的是她连向王都还没有跟她求，她就可能要面临一个被杀的状况。
And evenBefore she is able to ask of the king, she might have been killed.
所以真的犹太人他们整个面对这个状况真的是一个死局。
Actually, what the Jews face is a death sentence.
不是人可以去改变的。
It is not what human can change.
而是真的需要神的手来介入。
Really need the intervention of the hand of God.
所以他们为什么要来到一个禁食祷告？
Therefore, why they come to fast and pray?
但我们也思想到，以斯帖其实当初他得的这个位分，真的就是为现今这个时刻。
Really, when we think about this, the position that Esther received is really for such a time as this.
所有的牧者同工还有弟兄姐妹，神都有给我们预备属于我们的那一份。
Pastors, colleagues, brothers and sisters, really the Lord has prepared the portion for us.
还有属于我们的位置。
And also our position.
这个的位置是由我们需要去活出来、去行出来的事情。
This position, we can use it to do something and live out something.
神都有赋予我们这样子的一个意义在我们的生命里面。
The Lord has given us this meaning.
就像以斯帖。
Just like Esther.
她当初拿到了这个王后的位分，就是预备现今这个时刻。
When she became the queen, actually it is for such a time as this.
她是一个最好的人选去跟王求恩的那一个最佳人选。
And she is the best person who is able to go to plead the king.
但是她是人，她心中的挣扎，这是不能够去否认的。
Yet still she is a human and the struggle inside of her heart, we cannot deny it.
但是神的关键时刻需要有人，像昨天讲的一个关键的器皿起来去回应，去回应神的一个的呼召。
But in the critical moment,God need a vessel who is able to rise up and respond to this calling.
所以此刻的禁食祷告对以斯帖来讲就非常的重要。
Therefore, fast and pray at this moment of time is very important for Esther.
因为要把她心中所有会拦阻她往前的东西，透过禁食祷告要把它拿掉。
Whatever is hindering her before her need to be removed through fast and pray.
透过这个祷告，让她在此刻呢，她是做一个超越的行动，她可以跟神的心意连接上，而去回应神要她做的事情。
And to this.Prayer, she is able to respond to the will of God to do whatever is beyond her ability.
禁食祷告很多时候是帮助我们可以再次跟神连接更深，而且靠着他的能力，我们去行出他要我们做的。
Through fast and pray, we can have a deeper relationship connection with the Lord and do what surpasses our ability.
另外，这个禁食祷告为什么这样子重要？是因为这是一场的大征战。
Another thing why fast and pray is very important because this is a battle.
Haman 的这个族群呢是亚甲族。
And Haman is from the tribe of Agagite.
也就是亚玛利人的后裔。
The descendants of the Amalekites.
从历史里面我们看到神的心意是要灭掉亚玛利人的。
And from the history we know that the will of the Lord is to destroy completely these Amalekites.
生命记25章17节这样说，你要纪念你们出埃及的时候，亚玛利人在路上怎样待你，他们在路上遇见你，趁你疲乏困倦，击杀你近后边软弱的人，并不敬畏神，所以耶和华你神使你不被四围一切的仇敌扰乱，在耶和华你神赐你为业的地上得享平安。那时你要将亚玛利的名号从天下涂抹，不可忘记。
In Deuteronomy chapter 25, verse 17 to 19, remember what Amalek did to you on ways as you were coming out of Egypt, how he met you on the way and attacked you rear ranks, all the stragglers of your rear, when you were tired and weary and he did not fear God. Therefore it shall be, when the Lord your God has given you rest from your enemies all around in the land which the Lord your God is giving you to possess as an inheritance, that you will blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. You shall not forget.
在出埃及记十七章十四节也有这样说，耶和华就对摩西说，我要将亚玛的名号从天下全然涂抹。
In Exodus chapter 17 also mentioned by Moses that the Lord will blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven.
十六节也这样说，耶和华起了誓，必世世代代和亚玛利人征战。
And also in verse 16 mentioned that the Lord will war with the Amalekites from generation to generations.
是耶和华起来说要世世代代跟亚玛利人来征战。
And the Lord has said that he will rise up to war with the Amalekites from generation to generations.
为什么神这样子的去厌恶亚玛利人呢？
And why the Lord look at the Amalekites as an abomination?
一定要把他们灭绝呢？
And to destroy them.
因为当以色列人在出埃及的时候，他们竟然去杀在整个团队里面被 背后那些软弱的人，亚玛利人是一个一个去把他杀掉的。
And because when the Israelites came out from Egypt, these Amalekites attacked them from rear ranks and to destroy them.
我们知道那时代当以色列人出埃及的时候，周围的很多民族其实听到这个民族其实有一个敬畏在里面的。
And we know that at the time when the Israelites came out from Egypt, many nations when they heard of the Israelites, actually there are fear inside of them.
很多民族其实根本不敢去对他们动手。
And many nations not dare to attack them.
但是亚玛利人却不是。
But the Amalekites, they are different.
所以神说到他完全不敬畏神。
And they did not fear God.
也就是说，他们其实一点都不怕神。
And it means that they are not afraid of God even a little bit.
甚至不把神当作一回事。
They did not put God in their eyes.
所以神就对着以色列人说，要世世代代跟这个的民族来征战。
Therefore, the Lord says that you shall war against these Amalekites from generation to generation.
所以我们看到亚玛利人，他背后是一个古老黑暗的权势。
And we can see that there is this ancient power of darkness deep rooted in the Amalekites.
这么根深蒂固的一个黑暗权势是需要神超自然的一个能力介入来解决的。
Such a deep power of darkness need the supernatural intervention from the Lord in order to settle this.
我想它背后的这个黑暗权势也是一个敌基督的灵。
I believe this power of darkness behind is the Antichrist.
跟神对抗，跟神的百姓来做敌对的动作。
Go against God and also the people of God.
这么硬的东西是需要透过禁食祷告来把它做摧毁的动作的。
Such a hard case, we need to have fast and pray in order to face it.
我觉得神预备这个以斯帖这个事情很特别。
And God is preparing Esther in such a manner is so special.
原本在扫罗时代，扫罗王时代，应该是要灭掉亚玛利人的。
Supposedly in the time of King Saul, these Amalekites shall be blotted out.
但他爱他们的东西，他没有把他们灭掉。
But because he loved all these good things in the Amalekites, he did not destroy them completely.
扫罗是便雅悯族。
Saul is from the tribe of Benjamin.
莫迪改也是便雅悯族。
Likewise, Mordecai is also from the tribe of Benjamin.
感觉好像过去的东西没有完成，今天在这个时刻，神要做一个的处理。
Seems like what has not been completed in the past, now the Lord wanted to settle it once again.
所以这个禁食祷告就在这个瞬间呢，启动了这些东西。
And this fast and pray activated all this at this time.
是一个神的国跟恶者的国度一个的交战的时刻。
A battle between the kingdom of God and also the kingdom of the evil.
过去未打赢的，今天神要做一个总的处理。
What has not won in the past, the Lord wanted to settle this.
在这个过程里面，我们也看到莫迪改他的回应是非常的坚定。
And from here we can see the determination of Mordecai is a steel.
他相信神必定要拯救他们。
And he believed that the Lord shall surely deliver them.
透过这个禁食祷告，我们看到接下来两章很多事情虽然没有神的名字在里面。
Through fast and pray, we can see continuously these two chapters, though the name of the Lord is not mentioned,
但是却启动了那个转捩点，一个转机进到犹太人的族群当中。
But has activated a turn around among the Jews.
三天三昼三夜的禁食结束之后呢？
After 3 days and 3 nights of fast and pray,
以斯帖他就穿着朝服，也就是第三日之后，他就穿着朝服准备去见王。
And Queen Esther put on her robe and ready to meet the king.
三是神的时机。
Three is the timing of God.
在第五章跟第六章呢，我们会特别看到第三日，还有那日，还有那夜。为什么神特别强调这些的时间呢？
And from chapter 5 and 6, it mentioned that 3 days, and that day and that night. Why did the Lord mention of this timing?
我感觉到是神透过这个的时间在告诉我们，因着禁食祷告，现在的时间是进到神完全的掌权里面了。
And God, the Lord is telling us in this timing through fast and pray, we are entering into the time of God.
第五章二到四节这样说，王见王后以斯帖站在院内，就施恩于她，向她伸出手中的金杖，以斯帖便向前摸杖头。王对她说，王后以斯帖啊，你要什么？你求什么，就是国的一半也必赐给你。以斯帖说，王若以为美，就请王带着哈曼今日赴我所预备的宴席。
Verse 2 to 4. So it was when the king saw Queen Esther standing in the court that she found favor in his sight, and the king held out to Esther the golden scepter that was in his hand. Then Esther went near and touched the top of the scepter. And the king said to her, What do you wish, Queen Esther? What is your request? It shall be given to you, up to half the kingdom. So Esther answered, If it pleases the king, let the king and Haman come today to the banquet that I have prepared for him.
当王向以斯帖伸金杖的时候，
When the king set out this golden scepter,
这是因着前面的禁食带来的王对他一个施恩。
It is a favor from the king to Queen Esther after this fast and pray.
而且很出乎意料的，我们看到这个王是马上说，以斯帖啊，你想要什么，就算我国的一半给你都没有问题。
And beyond her expectation, that is immediately the king said that, Queen Esther, what is your request? It shall be given to you even up to half the kingdom.
这个突破律法有一个的转变，我觉得是因为他们的禁食祷告，神已经在灵界上面先对犹太人伸了那个金杖。
And this is beyond the decree. That is when they come to the king, and through this fast and prayer, the Lord has even held out this favor to the Jews.
反映到这个的物质界里面来。
It is reflected in this material world.
这个时刻，其实以斯帖大可以跟神马上讲，跟这个王讲，哎，哈曼对我们做什么事情？
At this time, actually, Queen Esther can tell the king that what Haman has done to the people group.
但是他没有。
But she did not.
他反而跟王讲说，我预备宴席，邀请王你来参加，还有请王带着哈曼一起来。
She just mentioned that she has prepared a banquet for the king and asked the king to bring along Haman together.
第九节就讲，那日哈曼心中就快乐，欢欢喜喜的出来，但见莫迪改在朝门不站起来，连声也不动，就满心恼怒莫迪改。
And verse 9 said that, So Haman went out that day, joyful and with a glad heart. But when Haman saw Mordecai in the king's gate, and that he did not stand or tremble before him, he was filled with indignation against Mordecai.
我们可以看到哈曼他其实心中已经更多的沾沾自喜。
And we can see that Haman is so happy about himself.
王后谁都不请哦，就是请他而已。
The queen did not invite anyone, he just invited me.
哇，那个的开心，觉得自己好像是某人一样，好像很有威一样，很威风一样，那个感觉全部在他里面。
The joy inside of him, because he thought that he was somebody.
而且呢，他把他这些东西啊，都告诉他的太太，告诉他的儿女们，告诉他所有的在他底下的，无论臣仆，都告诉他们。
And he told all that happened to all the multitude of his children, his wife, and even his official and the servants of the king.
我相信在十二节这里，他这样子在讲的时候，他是大声的说：“哈曼又说，王后以斯帖替我预备宴席，除了我之外。”不许别人随王复习，明日王后又请我随王复习。
And verse 12 also mentioned that the queen did not invite anyone, just me, the Haman. So tomorrow she will invite me once again to the banquet.
他的心中那个的自意自满，觉得自己是很有用的，越来越多，越来越多。
The pride inside of him and also self-satisfaction has become greater inside of him.
而另外一边，我们刚刚有读到第九节那里，那里讲到，就是他看到莫迪改依旧不对他跪拜，他心中更是怒气填胸。
In verse 9 that we mentioned just now, when Mordecai saw Haman, he did not pay him homage, and his heart was filled with indignation.
所以呢，这些种种的加在里面，在第五章的最后呢，他就听了他太太的建议，去制作了一个木架，准备要把莫迪改吊死在那里。
And because of all this indignation against Mordecai, so he listened to his wife to build this gallows in order to hang Mordecai on it.
神的审判会临到，是当罪恶满盈的时候。
The judgment of the Lord will come when the evil inside of man's heart is fulfilled.
这整个过程，以斯帖透过筵席，其实也是一个等候，让神去做更大的工作在当中的一个时段。
So in all of this, Esther is waiting for the timing of the Lord for all.The work of the Lord to come to pass.
被邀请去一个筵席其实是可以很开心的，但是我们看到哈曼的开心是过的。
To be invited to a banquet, we are very joyful, because of this. But, the joy of Haman actually is beyond.
所以我们可以看到他的本质原本就是恶。
So we can see the nature inside of Haman is evil.
所以他的恶更加起来，其实神的时间就更是快速的临到。
So the evil inside of Haman was exaggerated, so the judgment of the Lord come quickly.
在第六章的一到四节，我们就看到那一夜王突然睡不着觉。
And in chapter 6, verse 1 to 4, we can see that night the king could not sleep.
他就命人取历史书来。
So he asked someone to take the book of the records of the chronicles.
正好念到莫迪改在过去所做的事情。
And it was read to him what Mordecai has done for the king.
救了王的事情。
And he saved the king from being killed.
王也问说，哎，那时候有没有对他有做一个赏赐呢？
Then the king asked, what honor or dignity has been bestowed to Mordecai?
那一个的仆人就说没有。
And the servant said no.
这章感觉有很多的恰巧的事情。
And in this chapter, there were a lot of coincidence.
恰巧这一夜王睡不着。
And coincidentally, the king couldn't sleep at that night.
我相信王的府库应该是很多书卷的。
So I believe the king has a lot of books with him.
怎么会那么恰巧就是拿到那一卷呢？
And what a coincidence that book was recorded was taken.
这么有这么恰巧，神又问他，那我有没有对他有任何的赏赐呢？
And a coincidence the king asked what have been done for Mordecai for this.
然后在第四节又这么恰巧，当王在听这个事情的时候，哈曼在外面。
And what a coincidence that when the king heard of this, Haman entered into the court.
而且第四节这里说，哈曼进宫正是要讲说要把莫迪改吊在木架上面的这件事情。
Haman just entered the outer court of the king's palace to suggest that the king hang Mordecai on the gallows that he had prepared for him.
但是却在哈曼要讲之前，先让王听到了莫迪改这个人。
Before Haman spoke of his suggestion, the king heard of the name Mordecai.
其实激起了王对这个人的感恩。
And bring out the feeling of gratitude towards Mordecai.
所以王最后就叫哈曼进来，就问他说，哎，王喜悦尊荣的人要怎样子做？
Therefore, the king asked Haman, what should be done to someone whom the king wanted to honor?
此刻哈曼还在很开心说，哇，那个王要尊荣的人一定是我啦。
At this period of time, Haman thought in his heart, whom would the king delighted to honor more than me?
就告诉他要让他骑上马啦。
And to let him ride on the king's horse.
要给他穿朝服啦，戴冠的御马啦。
And let a royal robe be brought with him.
然后在城里的街市呢，在那里绕行。
And also be to have a parade throughout the city square.
甚至要有人在面前说，有人在他的面前宣告说，这是王所喜悦尊荣的人啊，要这样子的待他。
And also proclaim before him, thus shall be done to the man whom the king delights to honor.
当哈曼讲完之后，王马上告诉他，你现在马上就去把这件事情做在莫迪改身上。
And after Haman has mentioned all this suggestion, the king said, hurry, take the robe and the horses that you have suggested and do so for Mordecai.
我相信他这此刻在他的心中很像那个叠叠乐那个乐高那个叠到很高那个 玩具一样。
I believe at this moment of time for Haman is like all the Lego that has stacked highly.
一碰全倒了。
When it was touched, it's fallen.
他的幻想破灭。
All his imagination was broken.
我相信他心中有一个 OS 啊，怎么会是他呢？
And inside of his heart, there is an OS asking, "Why is this man?
怎么不是我呢?
Why is it not me?
Oh no!
Oh no!
我想跟王讲的东西，我不可以讲了。
Whatever I want to speak to the king before this, I couldn't say anymore.
因为现在这个人，莫迪改这个人在王心中更是比他更重要啊。
Because Mordecai, this man is even more important than he himself.
他在讲说我要除掉这个人，他不是跟王作对吗？
If he tell the king that I want to destroy this man, isn't it? He is going against the king.
我们看到神的时间点刚刚好。
We can see that the timing of the Lord is just right.
不迟。
Not delaying.
所以让仇敌一点工作都不能够做成。
So the work of the enemy cannot be done.
所以我们看到呢，最后呢，这个哈曼在第六章最后呢，他就说到。他最后去把所有事情哦告诉他的太太。
And lastly, in chapter 6, we can see that he told everything to his wife.
虽然他的太太是跟哈曼站同边的。
Though his wife is standing together on the side of Haman.
但是真的无论什么人，神都可以用。
But no matter whom the Lord can use.
因为我觉得他好像对哈曼发了一个先知预言一样。
Because I felt that it as if she is prophesying to Haman.
他对哈曼说：“你在莫迪改面前死而败落。他如果是犹大人，你必不能胜他，终必在他面前败落。”
If Mordecai, before whom you have begun to fall, is of Jews' descent, you will not prevail against him, but will surely fall before him.
他已经预言了他的一个结局。
And she already prophesied his ending.
所以这整个过程，我们看到从那个禁食祷告开始，到这个时间点，神向这个王向以斯帖伸金杖。
And from the whole process, we can see from fast and pray until this timing where the king has held his golden scepter.
禁食祷告是那个 key point, 是那个转动的钥匙。
Fast and pray is the key point to turn things around.
摩迪改也来到一个被尊荣的位置。
Mordecai also come to a stage where he was being honored.
原本无论是以斯帖或者是莫迪改都要面对死亡的一个命运。
Initially, regardless is Queen Esther or Mordecai, they will be killed.
但是就是因为禁食祷告等候神的工作，他们都进入一个神恩宠被拯救的一个时机。
Because of fast and pray and they wait for this timing of God, they were being honored by God.
我们大家都知道其实读以斯帖是很 last minute 的。
We know that this book of Esther it was chosen in the last minute.
然后就这么刚好今天是读四到六章。
And coincidentally, today we are reading chapter 4 to 6.
讲到祷告。
Mentioned about prayer.
我们所有同工，我不知道你们的感觉如何，但是我觉得感觉很真实，因为我们昨天在微线祷告殿做那个烛坛。
I do not know how you feel, but for me, yesterday we just built the altar for preparation for building the house of prayer.
当我在预备的时候，我感觉到神很大声的跟我们讲，就是祷告是接下来很多转动，很多过去很古老的东西不能够突破的东西，祷告是那个的关键的东西，是要去做层层的突破的。
I felt that the Lord is telling me that the key is prayer in order to break all these ancient power of darkness or whatever that has have no breakthrough in the past, and prayer is the key.
祷告是神要我们在这时代要起来不断的去做的事情。
Prayer is what we need to do now to rise up to continue to do it.
当时候他们透过祷告进入神一个蒙恩宠一个被拯救的时机。
Through prayer at that time, they were delivered by God and also being honored.
今天无论疫情再怎么严重，
Today, no matter how serious is the pandemic,
无论接下来到底我们会面对怎样子的一个世局的变化，
or what we will face in the future, whatever changes it is,
但是这个建祷告殿不断的在当中，以后在当中有很多的祷告声音发出。
And when this house of prayer is being established, there will be a lot of prayers from that place.
我感觉到神在对我们说，祷告越多的发出，是让我们进入更多蒙神恩宠，还有一个被神拯救，从这个世代被救出来的一个的关键的很重要的一个钥匙。
I felt that if more prayers is being set out, the timing of the Lord to deliver and also to save us will happen.
所以弟兄姐妹，真的，我们建神的殿是势在必行的一件事情。
Building the house of prayer is something must go on.
而且是一件事情，将来我们要面对很多灵界上面的问题的时候，是让我们可以靠着神站立在仇敌面前，但是毫无畏惧。
This house of prayer is built when we facing this battle with the enemy, we can stand firm before God and without any fear.
神要让我们蒙恩再蒙恩。
The Lord wants us to have favor upon favor.
神要让我们蒙拯救再蒙拯救。
The Lord wants to deliver us and deliver us again.
让我们真的一起跟着教会同心来建这个祷告殿。
Let us follow the church together in unity to build this house of prayer.
让祷告的声音不断从我们当中发出去，真的震动整个的黑暗势力。
Let the voice of prayer be set out from this place to shake the power of the darkness.
我们一起来敬拜神。
Let us worship our God together.
感谢神，他是让我们能够得胜再得胜的神。
Give thanks to God because He is the one who causes us to have victory upon victory.
他能够让我们的生命得翻转。
If we can have a transformation in our lives.
我们透过祷告，我们能够翻转一切的事情。
Through prayer, we can have transformation over everything.
重点是我们在神对的时间里面做对的事情。
The main point is we do the right thing in the right time.
现在这个的时刻，我们就一起的来敬拜我们的神。
Let us all worship our God.
打开你的天窗，释放你的恩宠，权柄尊贵，让我们不断建立祷告的殿，让我们呼求你进入更深更透彻的翻转，你掌权改变这时代的黑暗权势，抓住你心意，在你落选时间里，一环一环我伤心，经历你从来的恩典，抓住你心意，在你落选时间里，一环一环我伤心，经历你不放弃的爱。释放你的恩宠，权柄尊贵，让我们不断建立祷告的殿，让我们呼求你进入更深更透彻的翻转，你掌权改变这时代的黑暗现实，心意在你落雪时间里，一环一环我伤心，经历你从来的恩典，抓住你心意在你落雪时间里，一环一环我伤心，经历你不放弃的爱。全世界里，一环一环我伤心，经历你从来的恩典，
The pastors, co-workers, brothers and sisters,
今天是很有恩膏的一天。
Today is a very anointed day.
今天是普尔节的第一天。
The first day of Purim.
是我们庆祝反败为胜的一天。
It is the day we celebrate from defeat into victory.
也是我们看到过去努力祷告，然后事情转变的一天。
It's also a day where we have fasted and prayed in the past. Now we want to see the transformation.
在这边以斯帖的名言说，然后我违例进去见王，我若死就死吧。第四章十六节下半段。
Here it mentioned the very famous quote from Queen Esther, and so I will go to the king, which is against the law, and if I perish, I perish.
因为这个的以斯帖跟莫迪改，所以呢才会有这个反败为胜。
Because of Queen Esther and Mordecai, we have this turning defeat into victory.
因为神有器皿愿意站在那个破口，让神使用。
Because there is a vessel willing to stand for God in the opening.
所以各位弟兄姐妹，今天我们站在一个非常有恩膏的一天呢，我感觉到神在呼召我们成为这个世代的莫迪改还有以斯帖。
In this anointed day, as if the Lord is calling all of us to rise up to be the Mordecai and also Queen Esther of this generation.
今天是我们做决定的一天。
Today is the day we make decision.
我们愿意吗？
Are we willing?
站在神量给我们的领域。
To stand in the realm that the Lord has measured for us.
我们的国家。
Our nation.
我们的公司。
Our company.
我们的家庭。
Our family.
我们的学校
Our schools.
神需要有莫迪改还有以斯帖。
The Lord need to have Mordecai and Esther.
这个器皿的用处呢，就是站在地上连接天上，让神的大能入侵地上。
And the work of this vessel is to stand on the ground and to align with heaven so that heaven can invade on earth.
说到底就是付上祷告的代价。
So you need to pay the price, that is to pray.
所以各位弟兄姐妹，我觉得神很急切的要兴起一般他的秘密武器，就是莫迪改还有以斯帖。
And eagerly the Lord want to raise up this secret weapon that is Mordecai and Esther.
我们这个时候就来到神的面前，我们单独的跟神对话。
At this moment of time, let us come before God to speak to the Lord.
我们在神面前问问我们自己，我愿意吗？
Ask yourself, are you willing?
愿意的话，我们可以跟神说，主啊，我愿意。
If you're willing, tell the Lord that I'm willing.
就算是要付上生命的代价，我也愿意。
Though I need to pay the price of my life, I'm willing.
我不知道未来会如何，但是神在这一个时刻，我愿意。
I do not know what will happen in the future, but right now, I am willing.
主啊，你来帮助我们。
Lord, come and help me.
来帮助我们所有的弟兄姐妹。
Help all our brothers and sisters.
主啊，我知道你很急切的要在每一个领域里面兴起这个祷告的器皿。
Lord, I know that eagerly you wanted to raise up this vessel of prayer in every realm.
是一个能够委身，直到就算没有了性命也愿意委身的祷告器皿。
This vessel of prayer is committed, even though need to pay the price of the life.
主啊，你来帮助我们。
Lord, help us.
主啊，你来帮助我们。
Help us, Lord.
主啊，在这个时刻，让我们可以勇敢。
At this period of time, let us be bold.
主啊，你将这个勇敢的心赐给我们。
Lord, give us this boldness.
赐给我们。
Give it to us.
赐给我们。
Give it to us.
弟兄姐妹，这个时候我们来回应神，是否我们要成为那个神可以使用的祷告器皿？
Now is the time for us to respond whether we are willing to be this.Vessel of prayer.
让我们自己跟他说。
Let us tell God.
愿意还是不愿意。
Willing or not willing.
说出来，让你自己都能够听到这个声音。我愿意。
Speak it out so that you yourself can listen to it.
主啊，我愿意。
Lord, I'm willing.
我愿意成为以斯帖跟莫迪改。
I'm willing to be Esther and Mordecai.
主啊，我愿意成为那个祷告的器皿。
I'm willing to be the vessel of prayer.
主啊，我愿意站在地上连接天上，让神你的大能能够入侵地上。
I'm willing to stand on the ground to connect with heaven so that heaven can invade on earth.
主啊，我愿意。
Lord, I'm willing.
主啊，我愿意。
I'm willing, Lord.
主啊，这个时候你将这个的负担，主啊，放在我们的心里面。
Put this burden inside of our heart right now.
放在我们的心里面，让我们对神你所量给我们的领域有真实的这个的迫切的感觉。
put it inside of our heart so that we can feel the urgency.
主啊，来恩膏我们。
Anoint us, Lord.
主啊，祷告的大能现在释放给我们。
To release to us His power of prayer.
主啊，勇敢面对属灵界跟撒旦的这个的国度的这个交锋的勇气，主啊赐给我们。
This courage to face this battle between this spiritual realm between God and also the evil one.
圣灵现在来膏抹。
Holy Spirit, anoint us.
更多的膏抹。
Anoint us.
更多的膏抹。
More anointing.
更多的膏抹。
Anoint us more.
弟兄姐妹，我看到神向我们伸金杖。
Brothers and sisters, I saw that the Lord is helping up this golden scepter.
这个的金杖能够让我们可以很快的跳进去神给我们的命定里面。
And this golden scepter is helping us to quickly go into our destiny.
如果我们愿意接受神这个邀请的话，我们举起我们的手，我们去摸这个的金杖。
If we are willing to respond to this invitation, then let's lift up our hands and touch this golden scepter.
就在这个时刻，举起你的手去摸这个的金杖。
Right now, raise up your hand to touch the top of this golden scepter.
主啊，我们在这里。
Lord, we are here.
主啊，我们在这里。
Lord, we are here.
主，今天我们摸着神你的金杖。
Today we are touching your golden scepter.
主啊，跟神你说。
And to tell you, Lord.
来使用我。
Use me.
来使用我。
Use me.
主啊，不管未来如何，我相信你。
No matter what will happen in the future, but I believe in you.
因为你是一个反败为胜的神。
Because God, you are a God who turning defeat into victory.
主啊，你让一切的忧伤变为喜乐。
And all this sorrow into joy.
主啊，我们愿意。
We are willing.
有着神你的恩典，我们勇敢地踏出去。
With your grace, we are willing to step out.
主啊，来使用我们。
Use us.
主啊，来使用我们。
Use us.
主啊，谢谢你。
Thank you, Lord.
更多的来恩膏我们。
Anoint us more.
主啊，我们期待。
With expectation.
有大事将要发生。
That great things will happen.
主啊，在众人的祷告之下，有大事将要发生。
Among the prayer of the people.
主啊，我宣告，我们很快很快会看到很多很多反败为胜、反忧为喜的事情发生。
We will see a lot of defeat turns into victory, and also a lot of sorrow turns into joy.
主啊，是一样接着一样的，主啊，没有间断的发生。
One by one happening without stop.
主啊，我们感谢你。
Lord, we give thanks to you.
将所有荣耀归给你。
We give you all the glory.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
我们不愿停留在现在，更多祷告寻求你的面，更深明白你心意。我们不愿停留在现在。
弟兄姐妹，
dear brothers and sisters,
今天真的是看到神的时间。
Today we really see the timing of God.
特别是在第五章，
especially in chapter 5,
第六章，
and chapter 6,
第三日，
on the third day,
那日，
that day,
今日，
today,
很多的这些的字眼出现，
a lot of such words appear.
我想，以斯帖，他怎么会要等第二天呢？
And why is Queen Esther waiting for the second day?
难道她知道当天晚上神要做这件事情吗？
Did she knew that the Lord would do this?
就好不容易越了王哦，为什么不当天就做这件事？就跟王要。
And not easy that she is able to meet the king, and why not she ask request from the king?
所以她等了第二天。
So she waited until the second day.
所以。有时间给神当天晚上做一个翻转的工作。
That is, she let God have time to do this transformation on that night.
我觉得那个三昼三夜的祷告是非常的重要。
and prayer and fast for 3 days, day or night,
让我们的心思所有的东西都跟神对齐
is very important in order for our hearts, our minds to align with God.
可能当时我们不明白为什么我会 要等第二天呢？
Maybe we do not understand why do we need to wait for the next day.
但是我们就顺服当时的感动，就是第二天。
But we just obey the prompting that we have, that is to be obedient to wait for the next day.
神就在那里工作。
Then God will work there.
虽然仇敌那一天晚上也在工作。
Though the enemy also work on that night.
但是最终的得胜还是神。
But the eventually victory belongs to God.
这个的结果是因为有一个愿意的器皿。
The outcome is because there are vessels who are willing.
而且愿意顺服他的义父，就是他的上一代。
That is, she's willing to obey her previous generation.
所以当他跟莫迪改两个同心合意，两代同心合意的时候，他们就可以。打败靠着神打败这一个的敌人
So together with the previous generation Two generations united together They are able to defeat the enemy
600年前
600 years ago
撒母耳跟扫罗
Samuel and Saul
是扫罗没有不愿意去完成这件事情
Saul is not willing to complete this task
所以仇敌不能打败
Therefore, the enemy will not defeat it.
所以六百年后
600 years later,
这件事情重新的出现
And this incident appeared once again.
当两代同心合意
When two generations united together,
一起寻求神的时候
To seek God,
这个的仇敌就完全的被打败
And this enemy is completely defeated.
我在想到我们昨天当我们一起在筑坛的时候
I recall that yesterday when we are building the altar
仇敌也做了很大的事情
The enemy also did big things
就是要给你下大雨
That is to have heavy rain pour down
但是两代在这里一起同心合意祷告的时候
But when two generations united together and pray
天窗为我们打开
Even the windows of heaven is open for us
乌云满天
There are dark clouds all around
但在我们上面那个云开始敞开，乌云开始敞开。
But above,
靠边站。
But above us, the dark clouds started to disperse and to be back off.
所以我也要宣告。
So I declare.
我们过去三天三夜的禁食。
Our fasting and prayer 3 days and 3 nights.
弟兄姐妹
Brothers and sisters.
我们一定经历神的得胜
Surely we will experience the victory of God.
好不好我们一起来领受祝福
Let us receive the blessing.
天父
Father.
我们要谢谢你
We give thanks to you.
你透过一张一张一天一天这么多的一个见证告诉我们
Through the chapters and also in days you have told us all this testimony
你与我们同在
You were with us
得胜在于你
And victory is of, from you
主要我们宣告
We declare
过去我们所祷告的
Whatever we pray in the past
我们要宣告得胜在得胜
We want to declare that victories upon victories
是的主我们要谢谢你
We want to give thanks to you Lord
主要我们愿意成为那个器皿
We are willing to be the vessel
听神你的声音
to listen to your voice,
让神你做奇妙的工作
so that you can do marvelous things.
我们只不过是那个的器皿
we are just the vessel.
主啊我们要宣告过去我们所祷告的
we declare that whatever we have prayed in the past,
一件一件的事情
one by one,
在神你的手中
in your hand, Lord,
在神你的时间
in your timing,
必然成就
It will come to pass
谢谢你垂听我们的祷告
Thank you for listening to our prayer
祝福我们所有的弟兄姐妹
Bless all our brothers and sisters
奉耶稣基督的名
In Jesus name
Amen
Amen
好今天我们的晨祷就到这里了
Our morning devotion ends here
祝福大家
God bless you all